For what points p, x, y, z does the gradient of the function 25x squared plus 9y squared plus 16z squared have the direction from the point p to the origin? To start with, let us first write down the given scalar function, that is f, which is 25x squared plus 9y squared plus 16z squared. By using the definition of the gradient, which is del f, we will get 50x I cap plus 18y j cap plus 32z k cap. Let's now talk about the direction of the gradient vector. According to the problem, the direction of the gradient vector is from the given point to the origin, which means the gradient vector which we obtained here should be collinear with the position vector of the point P, which is OP bar, where O is the origin. If these two vectors are collinear, then one of them can be expressed as a scalar multiple of the other. Here I am calling that scalar as lambda, so lambda is any real number. Using the equality of two vectors, we will get 50x I cap equal to lambda x I cap, 18y j cap as lambda y j cap, and 32z k cap as lambda z k cap. Remember that the vector on the left hand side is the gradient vector which we obtained earlier, and the vector on the right hand side is nothing but the scalar multiple of the position vector OP bar. Equating the components, we get 50x equal to lambda x, 18y equal to lambda y, and 32z equal to lambda z, which gives us three different possibilities. The first possibility is that if lambda is equal to 50 and x not equal to 0, then that forces us to take y and z as 0, because if we let lambda to be 50 in the second equation, we get 18y equal to 50y, and this equation will be satisfied by only that value of y when it is 0, and same thing is going to take place with the z coordinate. So the first possibility is telling us that one of the required directions must be along the x-axis, where both y and z coordinates are 0. Let's now consider the second possibility, where we will apply the same process which we applied for the first equation. If 18y is equal to lambda y, then lambda must be equal to 18, assuming that y is not equal to 0, and in that case x and z coordinates will be 0. So the second possibility has given us the direction as the y-axis. And finally, if we consider the third equation, which is 32z equal to lambda z, which gives us lambda as 32, and for lambda to be 32, x and y should be 0. So the third direction is the z-axis. So answering the original question, for what points P does the gradient have the direction from P to origin, is as follows. Points lying on the coordinate axis.